Hi guys, so welcome to the next part where we are going to continue onward with our exploration of the 6-8 feel or the 6 rhythm pattern. So what we did earlier was just visualize it as triplets or else as divisions of 2 of a 3 beat per bar kind of a song. What we are going to do now is just look at accents a bit more and also try to build a few unique patterns, try to make it our own, sort of own it and make a song using it, if you will. So the first thing is let's look at a few accents. So if we divide 6 by 2 equal pieces, you're going to get simple triplets. Da 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 da. Right, so there are no accents as such because it's very even. Accents happen when there is some unevenness and that creates a little bit of syncopation. So the first thing I'd like to share is a busier 6x8 feel, what I call the busy feel. So there you group the 6-8 as 2s and 4s. So you do 2 plus 4. So that'll be 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. Right? It sounds a bit weird, doesn't it? It doesn't sound as natural as 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, or 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, and 2. All of those sound very normal, but when you say 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 1, 2, it just doesn't feel normal, but it sounds quite beautiful. Let's try and get it going on the piano now. So you go, so this is your chord again, D minor. Again, I am playing D minor with the top note copying the bottom note. That gives you that, it gives you a bigger sound, it gives you more options for your arpeggio, and it's just what's there when it comes to a 6-8 kind of a feel. Okay, so you go, this is how I would play a 2-4 busier 6-8 feel. You do 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. So what am I doing there? I'm kind of not going fully down initially, I'm not going all the way down, I'm going 1, 2, and repeating 1 2 3, so that creates a very unique accent. 1 3 4, 1 2 dun, dun. You're sort of stressing the note not at the predictable point, which is at ta ta ta. Now it's uneven, da 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 da. So just try focusing this on the D minor chord. Maybe play those accents in your bass. Okay, then you can proceed towards the other chords. Right, so that's another way you're doing 6. It's sounding a lot more busier and a lot more forceful, a lot more aggressive, I guess. Quite like it. Little more to think though, because it's not even, isn't it? 2 and then the 4. Another thing you could do with the 2-4s, you could complement it with the left hand by just holding your ground and playing normal steady triplets. 2 3 1 2 3. I'm just keeping a 3 going there, you know. 2 3 1 2 3. Assuming it's a 3-4. One, two, one, two, three, four. One, two, one, two, three, four. Okay. And to make this a little bit lazier, as I guess it feels like to me, you do 4 plus 2. So you do 1 2 3 4 1 2. 1 2 3 4 1 2. For 1 2 1. How did I do that? I come all the way down. 1 2 3 4 1 2, and then you do the 2. So you sort of invert what you did earlier. Now, so 1 2 3 4 1 2 1 2 3 4 1 2 1 2 3 4 2 1 2 3 4 1 2 1 2 3 4 1 2 1 2 3 4 1 2 1 2 1. And what's also happening is it's creating some very interesting accents which could also inspire your melody line and make these chords sound very, very unique. Like the chords itself are becoming a melody in this case, right? keep that 3 going in your bass. That'll also complement very well. Oh, sorry, that was the busier one. Let's do the lazier one. 3, 4, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. 3, 4, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. Ta-da, almost like a swing feel. Tang chicka tang 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 tang chicka tang, and so on. So that was your 2-4 or your 4-2 feel. The 2-4 makes it a bit busier. The 4-2 makes it a bit, I guess, lazier, if you will. I'm just putting names to this. Very, very unofficial, but it just feels like that to me when I practice it. So again, we've taken 6 beats in a phrase or in a cycle, but we've grouped it unevenly. In the earlier part, we grouped it in 3s or 2s. Now we've grouped it 2 plus 4, 4 plus 2. And as you may know, if you know your maths, 2 plus 4 equals 6. 4 plus 2 equals 6. And we are still in the 6 world. Right, guys, so now that we've explored the busy and the lazier feel, let's look at growing our accent vocabulary. But instead of taking a cycle of 6, we are going to sort of double that into a cycle of 12, or 2 cycles of 6, if you want to call it that. Now, when you do a cycle of 12, you have more options. You can use some odd number groupings, combine them with more even number groupings. As you saw with busy and lazy, you could combine 4 and 2 and 2 and 4 together, but those are even numbers. With the bigger cycle, maybe you do a cycle of 12, you can do, you know, the odd number groupings. Like maybe we can try 5 plus 4 plus 3. What is that? 5 plus 4 equals to 9. 9 plus 3 equals to 12, which is still 2 sets of 6, or 6 2s are 12, right? This is a maths class also, by the way. Anyway, so if you want to build 5 on the piano, what you could try to do. So try to count 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And figure out a kind of a pattern. Anyway, you have your 4 notes, but now you have to add one to make it 5, isn't it? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So I think I kind of like that for now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Starting with the pinky on the top. Now, after doing 5, I need to do 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then 1, 2, 3. Where I'm starting from the bottom. So that 3 is from the bottom. So maybe practice each of it separately and then piece it together. It's your 5, 4, 3. Okay, of course, you can't do it with gaps, otherwise it won't actually give you that 12 set or that 6 feel over 2 cycles. 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3. So it's, as you can see, it's very irregular, kind of tough to play also, isn't it? Because it's not, you don't move with the pulse, your piano is doing all sorts of things, but this could still be pulsed out because it's still 3. If you think about it, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 1. So if you count, if you snap your fingers, you could actually do a normal 3. You can snap like that, you know. So you can get some kind of a regularity with your other hand, with your left hand, to simulate a pulse of your choosing, okay? Okay, for starters, however, let's just maintain the accents just to show you. Change. And then you do the G and it goes on and on over this phrasing. Fine? So, or you could do something consistent. But for starters, maybe you don't want to do too much with the left hand, otherwise it creates too much of confusion because your right hand's already doing something odd. Yeah, so that's another way to use the six feel, where you take it over two cycles and then do different accent groupings. In this instance, I've chosen 5 plus 4 plus 3, which still equals to 12. So eventually it feels the listener will move. The listener will move to the pulse, but you're presenting something unique, which they can remember your song by. What I wanted to end with in this series is to kind of show you how you can make a melodic pattern as well using a 6-8 feel. And what I'm going to do for that is just take a chord, the same chord, D minor. You don't have to play the octave as well. You can just take the same triad, D, F, A, and add one note to this, which is a non-chord tone. Okay, so a non-chord tone with D minor could be E. E is still part of the scale though, right? It's still part of the scale in which all these four chords came from, but it's not a chord tone. It's not part of the D minor triad. So you could do E as your fourth note. Remember, for this whole 6x8 discussion, we used four notes instead of the usual triad, which gives you three. So the fourth note I'm going to play right now for you is that, and let's try a 6 over that. Right, so in my opinion, this starts sounding very, very unique, and it's like it's not really just a pattern to accompany the melody or the singer. It's something where you are trying to actually play something rememberable on your own and very melodically at the same time harmonically. So if you do, or I'm just adding a B flat there, a B, C, E, G, or quite like that. You're like not playing the F at all. You're just playing two non-chord tones, the sus 2, the sus 4, and the perfect fifth. So maybe you could experiment. F major, C major, G major. Explore different options. Yeah. So you have a ton of options now. So essentially the tip or the suggestion I have for you all is you take a chord, D minor, you add a non-chord tone, example E, G, B, B flat, stuff like that, and play them. So you have three triad notes, D, F, A, and you have one non-triad note, in this instance E, or in this instance G, or B flat, C, stuff like that. And again, you weave that together in your arpeggio, going up, down, or down, up, and it creates a very, very unique sounding thing, right? And you don't have to keep the thing going in a very, very busy manner, right? You can also chill out a bit with your arpeggio by just doing, right, just stopping there. Here and there, just stop. Still, then you can go back to something else. So it's a nice world to be in. And if you have a song which you're composing over this feel, you have a lot of creative possibilities, especially if you like playing arpeggios, right? So that's how I've sort of structured this two-part series. In part one, we looked at the traditional way to feel the sixth time over triplets of four or two, or over eighth note sequences of three. And in this part, we've looked at ways to make it busier, a bit more different using accents, a lot more unique using irregular groupings, odd number groupings of notes. And we've also looked at creating unique patterns by looking at different chord tones. Right, guys, so I hope you found this lesson useful. And if you haven't already, please subscribe to our YouTube channel. Give us a comment stating anything you'd want us to cover in the near future. And what else can you do? Share the video with your musician friends. Thumbs up, all those nice things, right? So as always, see you in the next lesson. We'll be doing more very, very soon coming your way. Have a good one. Cheers.